Hey everyone, this is Chris from Recombu and I'm here with the Google Pixel phone, Google's new flagship 5-incher. I'm going to do a quick comparison side by side with the Samsung Galaxy S7, one of the best phones of 2016 so far, another top Android, just to see what the difference is. So, 5 inches versus 5.1 inches, in terms of actual size and everything, there's not much difference between the Pixel and the S7. The S7 is actually slightly dinkier despite having a slightly bigger screen. That's because of these nice thick bezels above and below the Google Pixel phone screen. In terms of the actual design and everything, both quite slender phones, as you can see there. Both reasonably light as well, around the sort of 150-ish grams mark. So not going to be weighing you down when it's in your pocket or anything, and a nice bit of heft to it all the same. Of course, the S7 is fully water resistant is one of its main benefits, so you can give it a Dunkin', whereas the Google Pixel phone, you don't want to be getting that one damp. It can put up with a bit of moisture, a little bit of rain and spray and all the rest of it, but you don't want to be dropping it in the toilet or your pint or anything like that by accident. In terms of actual the aesthetics as well, the Galaxy S7 rocks this very nice curved sort of glossy rear. It's certainly very comfortable in the hands when you clutch it, no sharp edges or anything like that. Although it does, as you can maybe see, get a little bit smudgy, shall we say, which is all the more apparent on this sort of light gold model. The Google Pixel, on the other hand, is only partially glossy. As you can see, the top half there is made of glass, while the bottom half and the edges are all metal, just like the metal edges of the S7. And that's nice and rugged, can take a bit of a pounding, although you do of course get the smudginess at this top here. But on this quite black model, that's actually the name of it, I didn't just make that up, the smudges aren't too obvious, they're sort of reasonably well hidden, so that's nice. As for the visuals, you get a nice sharp, crisp, full HD screen on the Google Pixel. It looks nice and sharp no matter what you're doing, flicking around the good old Android Nougat or watching an HD movie. You'll have to really cram your face up against the screen and squint really hard, and even then you'll struggle to see any individual pixels. On the Samsung Galaxy S7, it's actually sharper. It's a good quad HD screen, so lots more pixels crammed into every inch. But side by side, you'll struggle to really notice the difference, to be honest. They're both very, very crisp, sharp, detail-packed screens indeed. Great viewing angles, as you can see. No distortion or anything there. And on top brightness, I think let's just crank them both up to maximum. And as you can see, they will definitely do the job, cutting through any glare and the rest. So even on a sunny day, no problem in terms of actual visibility. So that's nice, and they're both colourful, nice colourful punchy displays as well. You get nice vibrant rich hues, which is great if you're enjoying a bit of photography and all the rest of it as well. Both phones also pack a fingerprint sensor as well, so it's beneath the screen here on the Samsung Galaxy S7, just built into the home button, and it's nice and nippy. And on the Google Pixel phone, it's here on the back, so you just when your phone is off, both phones, just basically tap your finger to it and it'll open right up. And it's super accurate in both cases as well. Very, very rarely will you see a fingerprint not recognized message unless your hands are a bit greasy or sweaty or something, so that's nice. In terms of the actual performance as well, both phones are super nippy. It's a Snapdragon 820 or an Exynos processor packed into the Samsung Galaxy S7, depending on your region. And on the Google Pixel, it is the new Snapdragon 821, so it is technically, I think it's up to 10% faster, but in everyday life and when playing games and all the rest, can't really notice the difference, to be honest. They're both very, 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 very nippy, and they should see you through the length of a 2-year contract as well. So it might show signs of aging first, but certainly if performance is your key issue, then you don't have to worry. You get plenty of storage packed into both phones as well, minimum of 32 gigabytes. You can also get up to 64 in the S7, while the Google Pixel goes up to 128 gig. But while the S7 is expandable via the SIM card / microSD memory card slot, unfortunately you can't expand the Google Pixel phone's storage. It's all built in is all you get. There is no Mac support for microSD. So a bit of a shame for if you take lots of photos, or if you like to carry around a large media collection. Google has kind of smoothed it over a little bit by offering you a free backup to the Google Cloud. Basically, Google Photos will back up all of your photos and your video at full resolution, no compression or anything. And that's for free for as long as you have the phone, basically, as far as they're concerned. So that's nice, but again, if you want to carry around lots of movies and the like, you're not going to be able to do it unless you stump up the extra £100 for the 128GB model. Battery life, you get 3000 milliamp battery in the S7, 2770 milliamp in the Google Pixel. We've only been testing this for a couple of days now. So far, it seems to last the day quite happily, even with plenty of use, which is good. The S7, you get about a day's worth of battery life per charge as well. And they both support fast charging as well, which is nice. So that's that. And then finally, you also have the camera tech, of course. If we get our handy Android down. Oh, that's me. Let's get rid of that. There we go. On the S7, it's super fast to focus. And you take shots basically straight away. Let's just turn the flash off because we don't need that, obviously. So yeah, super fast to focus, autofocus and manual focus, both super quick. And as you can see, just tap away and it takes photos instantly. You get plenty of extra modes packed in as well. You get full pro controls, for instance, which allows you to fiddle with white balance, ISO levels and all the rest of it. Panoramas, slow motion video modes, all the rest of it. And you can shoot up to 4K video as well with pretty decent, pretty respectable image stabilization built in. It's definitely one of the best cameras of the year, especially good in low light, we've discovered. On the Google Pixel, this is apparently the best smartphone camera of all time, according to DxO Labs in France, who tend to benchmark these things. And so far, again, we've been very, very impressed. It's a nice, simple app to use, but you do get some nice controls over like some color temperature and the rest. Flash, obviously, and control over brightness. And because of the fast autofocus and the nippy manual focus as well, it's again super fast to take photos. You can basically just hold down the shutter button, take lots of photos in quick succession in burst modes. And you do get a handful of extra modes as well, such as, for instance, panorama, slow mode, lens blur, which kind of adds a bit of a bokeh effect to the background, which it's not particularly great. Once again, you can shoot up to full 4K video as well. Otherwise, you can also shoot Full HD in 60 frames per second and all the rest. So again, a very versatile camera, seems to work well in a range of conditions. It's good in low light, but not as good as the S7, has to be said, in our tests so far. But yeah, check our camera review for more information and for full photos and samples. And we're doing a super test versus the S7 as well, if you want to see side-by-side samples. So that, in a nutshell, is the Pixel versus the S7. Of course, there's lots of other stuff that we haven't had time to go into, such as, for instance, you get the Assistant on the Google Pixel phone, which is kind of a bit smarter than the old Google Now Assistant. But yeah, in a nutshell, that's the hardware differences. Which one would you buy? Let us know in the comments below. And thank you very much for watching.